after this birth of my second child, I woke up one morning and it was like a light had been turned off in my brain. It was over. I had no more feelings. I had no more delight. I didn't want to get out of bed. Tears would just run down my face. It went on for weeks. I didn't find joy anywhere. I canceled appointments. I stopped caring how I looked. I didn't want anything. Pierre and I were concerned, and we knew that there was something wrong with my mental state, so we went and saw a psychiatrist. Oh my goodness, was he happy to have the Prime Minister of Canada in his office. For the first 20 minutes, he gave Pierre some very good advice on how he could change the health system in Canada. And then he finally turned to me and he said, I understand you're having a rough time. Baby blues, he told me. Baby blues, he said. Pierre, pay more attention to Margaret. I left with no diagnosis, no medication, no idea what was wrong with me. What I didn't know was that I was bipolar. It was at that time it was called manic depressive. And the truth of bipolar and why it's called bipolar is as deeply as you go into a depression, you will climb up into mania once a depressive episode is over, if you allow yourself to do. And we certainly are happy after we've been depressed to move into mania. Mania is wonderful. You may run away with the Rolling Stones. You can do anything you want. You don't have to think about the consequences. Because you're on fire, your mind is racing, you're brilliant. And if only you could just kind of slow down and get things done, but you can't sleep and you can't eat. Hypomania, everybody would love to live in a hypomania. What a good state, you're in charge, you can get projects done, you can be counted on, you can be relied on, you've got great ideas, and you've got that life in you, spark in you, and you do. What's happening with the mania, the chemical in the, that is causing us to go into this manic state is dopamine, and oh, if we could only bottle dopamine, oh my goodness, it's in charge of our innovation, of our new thoughts, our huge emotions, our tenderness, our horror, everything. And most of us have a healthy amount of dopamine in our brain that gives us enough spark to get into a wonderful creative world of, that we have in our brain. Some of us get so much dopamine, now they know from the scans they can do, flooding in our brain that we can't, the thoughts come too quickly. One comes right after the other. You're inspired to do this and then you're inspired to do that. There's some very common symptoms of mania. You'll spend all your money. You'll spend all your father's money if he'll let you, and your husband's, and anybody who will let you, because you really feel you're so smart, you're so powerful, because you have all this extra electrical, it seems to me, electrical energy in your brain, that you should just have everything you want. When you fall out of the manic state, as you will, then you fall right back into depression because your guilt is overwhelming when you see the destruction that's happened in your life, how you've let down the people who love you the most, how you've played so foolishly with hearts, other people's hearts, how you haven't thought, oh, I forgot to think about someone else other than me. Being mentally ill, being in the manic state is the most narcissistic and selfish state there could be. And if you're raised like I was by a good mother with five, you know, four girls, being selfish wasn't something that was lauded. So I would get into tremendous depression very soon, fall back in, so roller coaster up and down. The first time mania hit me, my depression was in the winter. I guess Pierre did pay more attention to me, and the sun came out and the snow went away, and Pierre called an election. It was 1974, and he hadn't had me at his side in 72. No connection, but he just about lost his government. And so this time he decided he'd have me at his side, which was great. I still had my baby nursing. Remember the planes then? Everyone had a personal little ashtray. And I was Earth Mother from, you know, Vancouver, North Van, so my little baby was not going to be on that toxic plane. So I let go of the baby very quickly and stopped weaning very quickly. Our hormonal fluctuations are sometimes just enough to trigger us into episodes. It's if you do something quickly. sometimes you're triggered. The election campaign was heady. It was powerful. It was exciting. I didn't eat. I didn't sleep. And when it was over, landslide victory. And when it was over, we went to Harrington Lake and for 3 weeks for a holiday. And I was restless. And I said, Pierre, can I go to Montreal for the day, please? Oh yes, of course. Go, take the car. Go. And I got to Montreal and went, oh, I need to go to Paris. So I bought a suitcase and I bought clothes. I didn't have a passport, but it was 1974. Bienvenue à France, Madame Trudeau. It was no problem. Pierre found out where I was because I had to go to the Canadian consulate in Paris because I was on my way to Crete. I was going to walk around Crete. I had this beautiful new camera, and I was going to walk around Crete. Why? I mean, I just left. I just went off. This was my first bout with mania, my first time that my mind had been racing in the way it was, where I just couldn't slow down.